What's going on, people? It's DJ Argue and his Link Up TV. Right now, you're watching a State of Grime.
You already know.
What are we saying? Is it a good place at the moment?
I feel like it's definitely doing better than maybe it once was, just because like social media is about, so like you can put music out there more. It's just accessible, isn't it?
More accessible.
But it's definitely not as popular as it once was, just because, not because it's doing any better or worse, but because other sounds are doing a bit better. And it's what's the in thing in it. But like everything is phases, like one moment this is popular, then it's not. Like, I feel like it's just going through a phase at the moment where there's a lot of people talking about it more than there are people actually doing it.
Yeah. Why do you think that is? Why do you think more people are talking about it rather than participating in Gram?
Because people like to talk shit all the time. People like to say they'll do this or they'll do that, and then they don't follow through with it. Like, people would rather bitch about, this is what Grime is, but rather than going to the studio and make a tune, or go and film a video, or go and do a something, like, they'll rather just bitch. But I don't know, and then I don't know, maybe a lot of the artists at the top of Grime, or whoever your top Grime artists are, maybe aren't making as much Grime music as people would like. Because people listen to a new song and then it's gone like 2 weeks later and they want another one.
Yeah, the lifespan's not as what it was.
Nah, definitely not. Mm. No.
So you've been following the Grime scene, Nast?
A little bit. You won't hear Grime in my car as much. I don't really, like, it's not an everyday go-to music for me. But, you know, the ones who are doing their thing will come to my attention at some point. And, you know, at that point is when I decide to, like, look into them and see what they're working with, or see if I'll take to them or not.
So what you're saying, so H made a statement where he said no one his age cares about Grime. Mm-hmm. I don't think he probably meant no one, but he's basically saying the majority of people under 19, 20 don't listen to Grime. Mm-hmm. What do you lot think about that? Do you think it's true or?
Nah, that's bullshit.
Do you think?
Yeah, but he fucked up because he didn't choose his words properly. To say nobody bothers about it means that there is no young spitters, which is a lie.
Yeah, he probably didn't mean literally, I'm saying, like,
yeah, if he's, go on.
What I think H was saying about that is, like, obviously, every, like he said earlier about, it's a cycle, isn't it? Grime is not the in thing right now. I feel like the drill is more popular than grime at the minute. And the kids younger than H, they've been birthed into the era of drill. So now they're taking on to that, and grime is just like the backseat, but drill's at the front. So what these kids will be doing now is writing and getting onto the drill. And it's almost as if H has probably worded it wrong and said it like it's vanished, it's not there, it's like dead. That's not true. Grime is not dead, because you know, a grime, someone could come out of the woodworks, make a banger in grime, make an absolute banger, and it will change their life forever. Do you get me? Financially and just like on a progressive level. So I don't think, I know grime's not dead, but it's just, you know, the kids in a new era, younger than 20, they might not be as aware of the grime industry as much as they are with what's current today with the drill.
All right, but do you think there's a lot of, like, obviously, how old are you now, Yizzy?
I just turned 20.
You just turned 20. So do you think there's a lot of youngsters doing grime? Like, when we go to grime sets, there's not, it's only a handful, like you and like your Tommy B's.
I feel like over the years, the numbers get a bit less and less, but that's because more and more people are coming up listening to drill and Afrobeats and other stuff rather than grime. So like, if this was like 15, 20 years, it would be like the reverse. But obviously times change, things happen. Yeah, but for me, it was never about the amount, because back in the day, there was loads and loads of spitters.
There was a lot.
But if you compare the amount of them to how many there was compared to like people that are still around now, the numbers are like really different.
It's mad, isn't it?
Mm. So it's like, it's not always just about the quantity of MCs, it's always going to be quality and like who's unique, who's doing their thing.
Yeah.
But yeah, I just think H probably could have worded that a bit better. But the thing that pissed me off was I saw a lot of backlash from a lot of like MCs and that talking shit to him. Like, someone said that he was basically dissing the scene that he come from, or the scene that paved the way for him.
He didn't say Grime was dead though, that's the thing.
No, but
he said Grime was dead.
He didn't say that.
Oh, he didn't.
He just said that no one his age cares about Grime.
No one his age. Well, he's probably, in that sense, he's speaking his opinion, innit? And probably the people around him, I can see why he would say that, because they probably don't care about Grime. So I don't know why he got the backlash from that.
So you think he's from Manchester. So
and he's from Manny, totally, and it's a total different thing as well. But even like the London kids, man, like, can you imagine like the 16-year-old right now running around talking about Dizzy? No, he's not. He's going to be talking about Heady One. Mm-hmm. Do you get what I'm saying? Or he's going to bring up someone like fucking, I don't know, RV or whoever these other Dig Dats and all of these guys. Do you get me? It's like, it's just like he said, it's just that the people his age, his generation younger, probably care more about the drill, innit? Mm. That's what I think he was trying to say. And that's where he is right now. He's over there doing the Keishas and Beckys and he's living that life. So it's like, do you get what I'm trying to say? Mm. I think he's gassed on that.
So let's talk about war dubs and stuff, because obviously...
that's how grime started.
Yeah, like, we're going to have to
see the war thing? The war thing is interesting still, you know. You see the war thing, that's what built grime. You have to understand, I remember that, like, in the beginning, like, even back to Will, you get me? Like, bare war dubs. Bare, like, there was a time where he had, like three, four man at his neck. Four man. Like,
what
like,
was the first, like, grime beef you, like, was deep in?
Ooh, blood. Hey. Hold on, mate. Who did, man? Because it weren't, like... All right, look, without no bossy, big-headed, nothing, yeah? Like, obviously, where I came from, the era I came up in and the people I was with, we weren't, like, lyrical war dub, man. You get me, man? Yeah. I was coming through with the man that was really coming for you. Do you get what I'm trying to say? So it's like, man weren't really talking no one's name these times. It got to the point when I think, when Nasty fell apart a little bit, you get me?
Right, so Nasty fell apart. I remember you, like SO, the younger SOK lot. These times you was DJing, innit?
Even that, all right, cool, let's even say that now. That was probably the first one, you get me? But that's...
You weren't even spitting.
I wasn't spitting, I was a DJ, you get me? I was a DJ. Firstly, Nasty was it, I was a DJ. Yeah, yeah. You get me? That was the first, like, the first drama that man had, the first passer we had that time. That was a madness still, but shout out to SOK still, car. To this day, man, them things have been resolved and we're cool. But okay. Yeah, it all went, you get me? Man was young, you know how it is. There's about fucking 50 man in one flat. And we're all just in there spitting bars back to back. You got man like Marcus, Titch was dead, SOK, look, man didn't know none of these guys. We're all in the room. It's being conducted by someone who can't manage no one. Do you get me? Like, the man who's in there conducting the whole thing that cannot manage none of us.
Yeah.
Like, we could all tell him to just sit down. Right. Do you get what I'm saying? And he's the man in between. Squad. Do you get what I'm saying? Yeah. And so now, he's like, yeah, go on, spit. They'll spit. We'll spit. They'll spit. We spit. It was just a fucking disaster waiting to happen. Do you get what I'm saying? So now all of my lot left. I was the last one, because these times we had a record box. It wasn't CDs. So now I'm packing up my records, my dub plates and that, yeah? So I'm in the room with all of them lot. So now they're talking all reckless. I can hear them talking. So I come downstairs. I told my lot, yeah, boom. The man are talking. So then, cut a long story short, I'm not getting his tea tight. It all went off outside. You get me? And then cool, now moving forward, yeah, that was the first pass that man had, and that was with SOK, but shout out SOK, Kais, all loving that, you get me?
Yeah.
What about you? Because obviously you've been quite active recently.
Yeah.
Well, that's sent for Jammer, because he owes me peas, and just because he's also like a fucking snake.
So is that for Lord of the Mics, or is that for separate things?
No, I can tell you about it straight, because it's...
But you see Jammer, without dissing him, without trying to defend him though, yeah? Can I say something? Can I say one thing about Jammer, yeah? Mm. And like, this is mad because he manages Lord of the Mics, yeah? So I think like that platform was epic to a point where it now fizzled to where it's like, it's not as exciting anymore. Mm-hmm. And I want to speak on that and like why you're saying he's this and that, yeah? Because
you've even sent for him.
I've sent for Jammer, but for other reasons though. But this was before, remember, like I said, like when I came in the game, it was like, man didn't know these guys. I didn't know Jammer. I've never sat in a room, but when I sent for Jammer, I've never sat in a room with him and had like, had even had a conversation, understood what this man was like. It was just like, you know, you're the other side. So like when I'm saying like, I understand like, I'll just send for anyone, his mentality.
To be fair, all the people I sent for, it wasn't just to send for anyone, it was actual shit that had gone on. So like, for Lord of the Mics, for example, I was meant to get paid X amount of money from, like, you know when Lord of the Mics go, they do shows, they do festivals and whatnot afterwards. And obviously, like anyone else.
That
like,
never had materialised though, did it?
Right.
That's not his fault though. Jammer's always trying to help people though.
Having said that, on the night when Lord of the Mics got launched, man wanted to come over and brag about, my bank account is going crazy, we're getting bare money, blah, blah, blah. Yet no money went into, or little amounts went into promotion. So that happened. And then there was also just the snaky business in general. Like there's a bonus round in my Lord of the Mics clash that was never meant to be in there. And he said, Yiz, your family, I've got you. It's getting taken out. I found out with everyone else at the launch that it got kept in there. Mm. How can you look a man and call him family and then snake man like that? Not just over peas, but over that as well. So I was like, cool, I know I'm never going to see that money.
Why didn't you want that round in there?
Because I didn't spit back in that round.
You didn't, did you?
No, I didn't. It was 3 rounds, and then if you want to do the bonus round, decide at the end of the third. I said I didn't want to do it. Other brother said he did. So I was like, cool, you can spit your bars to thin air. And then Jam was like, all right, cool, we're not going to put that out because you didn't say anything back. But instead, man's put it out now. So the narrative is, oh yeah, Yizzy didn't want to do the bonus round.
Okay.
So that's fucked. And then Dot Rotten messaged me on a hype one day on Twitter talking bare shit. You don't want this pen, you don't want smoke, you tried to impress P Money.
Dot Rotten
chats
bare shit, bruv.
No, but I was just like, he was like, oh, you done it, you said.
Dot chats bare shit. Did you see that picture of him when he was posted up with when Sneak, he had him up by the chin? But I couldn't believe that shit, bruv. I said to myself, see, don't talk shit on the internet. And that goes for any of the youths. Like, conduct yourself properly, innit? Don't ever jump out of your seat, because that's the reality of internet keyboard worrying. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Like, it's a joke to me. I don't feel sorry for him either. He's a grown man.
So what's he like? Because you used to hang about with him, didn't you? You and Grim.
I've never hanged about with him. Never
okay, done
about
tunes
him,
with
but
him.
I've done
stuff.
Tunes with
yeah,
him.
Okay,
but
not hang about.
Yeah, 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 yeah. I've done songs with him. I know what he's like. You get me? And I feel like people just need to understand how to control their demons. You get what I'm trying to say? Like, Dot, you can't take away from him. He's a talented guy. You get what I'm trying to say? He's very talented. He's productive. He's fucking sick on the beats. He can make beats. Mm. Do all of that shit, but. All of that's not enough for the kid. He still has to come out and act like he's some fucking kingpin or something. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, for me, it's just embarrassing for him, and it just shows you how sad his life must be for him to be acting this way when you've got all of that going
and you're
on.
You're talented, isn't it? And like, even as a producer, you're getting paid for making rhythms and what. Like, you're eating.
Anyone with a brain will know that this kid's there's something he's tapped, because like the way he's moving on the gram and that ain't even normal. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Mm-hmm. And then, like, when I saw that picture, I just knew, look, see, this is what happens. Mm. This is, you can't, you know, the powers, you can't defeat the powers, bro. Like, what you say will come back to you. Dot situation was scary, man, for me. Like, I always looked at him, always respect his music, his talent, his beats. But it's like, when I saw him doing all of that hype on the internet and just going, even just going after J1, you know? Like, J1's like a young artist who's trying to come up and do his thing. Yeah. You know, you're not even approaching him on a gram level. You're just on some bullshit about money and talking a whole heap of smoke. That's unnecessary. Like, we all know, like, so what's the point in that? I want people to really be able to come out and speak their mind and uplift people, and rather than just fucking be out here doing shit, bruv. You're lost. If you want to come at the young cat who's out here trying to grind like J1, whatever you think about him, is your opinion, you feel me?
Yeah.
But as a director, as a producer, like, you're going around, that's what I'm saying about pagan behaviour, because I'm not a man who just goes off what the internet says, you know? I'm a man who will look at you and know if you're up. Do you get what I'm trying to say? If you look like a op, talk like a op, smell like a op, then you must be a op. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Yeah. And that's facts, bro. That is facts. My man said it to a T, because he probably has the same mentality as man. So it's like, when I saw my man moving to J1 like that, I said, nah, man, you're up, man. You're a pagan, you get me? Because you ain't even got no real reason. My man's out here trying to bust up the thing, and you're talented. You could just be behind the scenes. Shut the fuck up, man. Don't even want to hear from Doc. We don't care about what you... Look, do you know what it is? You've ended your own career. I got nothing to do. I don't care about Doc like that, where I need to put him down. I'm just talking. This is my opinion, and this is my facts. This is my truth. So, my man killed himself because he probably had thoughts in his head telling him, just take a back seat. But you didn't, you ignored those, and now you've come out. The last thing man saw was you looking like some fucking, yeah, like you overdosed on fucking ket. Do you get what I'm saying? A man holding you and your eyeballs are red. You look like you just smoked a whole Z of weed, blood. Yeah, and you can't handle it. A man's holding you up because you're about to faint.
Do you know what I think is deep down? I think he thinks he's the king of grime.
He thinks he's the king of grime?
Yeah, but he must be.
See the production on Dot. Don't play with him, innit? That's why I don't like why he does that vocal. Shut up. Sit down.
Oh, you think he shouldn't spit? No, just shut up.
Just shut up, bro. What happened was, he's got bored, smoked weed, got high, jumped on the internet talking shit. Yeah? And then it led to him getting punched up. So this is what happens to people when they don't stay in their own lane. You don't need to be out here trying to preach to those dickheads who you was talking about earlier, the ones who say, AJ, and try stir you up, and then you fall into that. A lot of men are falling into that lane. Do you get me? They're letting those guys get the better, draw them out. Are you mad? Come on, fam. You have to keep it 100. Like, you're gonna get those guys who try to draw you out, but it's not about that. It's about just being like, you know, you gotta be your mindset. You gotta be focused and understand that no matter what you do, you're gonna get those guys. Do you get what I'm saying? So just keep it 100 to yourself and understand the lane you're in.
Obviously, you had that clash with Maxstar.
Yeah, me and Mac, but that was organised. Mm. That was organised. That wasn't like random. No one really had it. No one's really come at me like that, for real.
How did that clash come about then?
It was business. It was just business.
It was literally business.
It was business.
Did you know Maxstar from before, or was you aware of him?
I was incarcerated, and he was doing some. Him and Grimm were socialising, and when they were socialising, Grimm kind of brought him into our world. And that's another thing, man. You got to be careful who you bring around you. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Because this man, from what I understand, when I come home, he was acting like he was fucking, like Grimm was talking about him like he's cool and
So Grimm was actually hanging about with him?
He was hanging about with him. They done some songs and shit. They was in the record, they was in the studio, they was recording Rare. And then imagine when I'm clashing with this guy, he's talking about things that he's seen in my mum's ass. Talking about this and that, and da, 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 da. So it showed you. It showed you about how you can have people around you. It's all smoke and mirrors, isn't it? Like, you could smile in my face, but what you're thinking is a whole next thing. Mm. Do you get what I'm trying to say? So it's like, that's why it's like a lot of things, like, just no fuck niggas around. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Because if sticking to the point now, yeah. So like, when I come home, like, Jammer's hollered at me. He threw me opponents. You get me? Jammer's like, it's business.
Like, who else was in the mix then?
He threw me opponents. I can't remember. There were some other guys, but no one was as good as Maxstar. Maxstar was as good as it got. So that I said Maxstar. I said, yeah, I'll do this with Maxstar. That's the only one I'll take. Not because I had anything against him. Like I said, it was business. So I said, all right, cool, I'll do Max. He went off, I got the call back. It's cool, deal sealed. So now, this is what it is. I'm having to now look into this guy's fucking archive, see who he is, what's his back, air to the streets, that wrote my little lines and whatever. Took it to the booth, done my thing, and then, like, that was that, innit? Me and Max had a clash. That was it.
How do you think the clash went?
I think it was ugly, man. It's ugly. I don't even want to talk about it, man. Yeah. Shout out Maxstar, man, all day. Shout out Maxstar all day long, man, because you get what it is. It's business. It's strictly financial, but sometimes there's the moral ground as well, innit? And you see me, I'm a realist. Like, sometimes you got to fucking you get me. Stick to the code. Yeah.
And do you feel like you broke the code?
Yeah, no, 100% broke the code, yeah.
All right, cool, we'll say no more. Yeah, I feel what we need to do as well, when, like, people, like a young guard, want to do Graham, instead of criticising them, we need to get behind them. Because it's going to make people not want to do, like, the youngsters, like you do get criticised a lot.
Yeah, but at the same time, I get
anyone thinks they can do music now as well.
Yeah.
That's another accessible thing. It's too accessible.
Like, you see, like, now you just go on, like, Instagram and there's some cunt, like, who's just popped up on the sponsor, like, fucking talking all this trap shit. And he's got a pair of fat Balenciagas on. Yeah, and he's standing in front of an AMG. He's talking bare shit. No, and you're
tell
like, what
people
the fuck?
What it was like back in your day coming through in Grime. Like, obviously, you started as a DJ on Pirate Radio stage. Tell them, like, how dangerous and
that was the day
DTI.
That was more realer than rap. You see, that like, what you talk about now on, like, the rap shit and drill shit. Mm. Like, that man can't diss Grime, realistically. Because when man was coming out in Grime, we never had no internet. Do you get me? That's why people were getting bored up and people were getting run at. You know how many, like all the clubs like Stratford Rex, Palace Pavilion, Young Man Standing and all of these things. You see, when you're entering them places, you got to enter with caution, you know, because it's not like, you don't even know what your enemies look like. You understand? So now you just know, right, you just know the front line and you know that's it. And anyone in that front, anyone in that thing, anyone can come at you. So it was very much more, you know, of a risk take, like risky roads, and that's how them kind of DVDs were getting created, because that was real. That was born from an era of risky roads. Do you get me? And like another thing about UK, about grime, is that, you know, it was made here. It was a lifestyle, you know. It was something that, it was an opportunity to, you know, become something, and also, like, you know, a passion that man always had. Like, there was a time, like, when Dizzy, imagine, like, I Love You, and that, like, there was no internet. I remember, like, seeing Dizzy, like, coming to my mum's. Like, you get me? He come there, and I'm like, looking at him, thinking, I'm like, man, it's almost pretty much starstruck. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Like, and, like, just those kind of, that kind of feeling. Like, that you can't get that back now, because everything's changed. No one's got as much respect for a man like that now, because now you can just see him when you want. You can almost feel like you know him because you're on the gram with him. And or, like, do you get what I'm trying to say? So
it's much more personal now, isn't it?
It's more personal.
It's a bit more elusive, but then, like,
it's just like now, no, people, artists come into the game, they don't. You see, before, you had respect for the guys who was at the top. I don't think that's there no more. I think there's a lack of respect for people.
What, from people or from artists?
From artists, yeah. Just to confirm that, I think from artists, because I think what artists know is that they just need the internet.
It depends what scene, because, like, all the younger grime people, like my age, or even anyone that's, like, younger than the Wiley generation, everyone looks up to select people in that group. They'll have respect for them.
Have you ever looked up to Wiley?
I'd be lying if I said I didn't. I can't.
But you sent for him.
Yeah.
Exactly. That's what I'm talking about. That's the lack of respect. It's like,
well, no. Sending for him doesn't mean I don't respect him.
Yeah.
It just means we've had an issue around this, and I don't like you as a person for that.
You don't have respect for someone and then publicly try to violate them or try to diss them publicly. What you would do is slide in their DMs or confidential.
Tried that.
And try to. Try to, like, off your whatever it is that's bothering you. But you see, when you come out like that and, like, come at man, it's like, it's all fun and games, I get it, but the respect's gone.
But that's one thing I will say, obviously, that if we're talking about Wiley in general, I've had plenty of conversations with Wiley and I've tried to find a workaround, but it didn't happen. Like, I don't even want to get into it, but I've tried that and it didn't work. So that's when I took to putting it.
Because you see, me, I respect Wiley. No way. Because he's done a lot of things to me that I could have easily just flew back to the pen. But I don't want to. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Out of respect. Not because I can't, because there's nothing stopping me from doing that. But it's just out of respect. I wouldn't do that. Do you get what I'm saying? But there's like,
times where you,
yeah, he's let me down. Like, he's said things.
But I think maybe that's a generational thing, because people imagine it are much more quicker to say stuff now.
That's what we were saying. Like,
that's the thing. I don't regret anything I said or done or anything in that situation or any situation. But I was feeling it a type of way at a time, and I felt I was justified, so I spoke out about it. I was raised like that. If there's a problem, talk it up.
Is there any chance that maybe you'll do tunes with them in the future, or the beef will get squashed?
Nah. I think Jammer doesn't like that. I called him a pork dread, so that will probably never happen. No, but he's spoken to people and asked them to stop supporting me and whatnot.
Oh, you know what's mad though? Yeah, you see Jammer, yeah? It's like he fucking. I feel like he was onto Lord of the Mics, yeah? And I don't think Lord of the Mics is as great as it once was. And I say that to say this. Definitely because not. I think. You see the last big clash, or the big anticipated clash that everyone was looking forward to?
No,
it wasn't even P&H. That got done, but that the real clash that should have happened was P&G.
Who?
Getz.
Oh, Getz. Oh, yeah, that was ages ago. Yeah.
No, but that is what should have happened. And then at that point, after that, it's when all of these other things that happened, even like me, Max, Cozzy and all of them man there. But
the Cozzy and Socks was quite big.
But P and G should have happened, and
that
then
would have been the one.
He should sit tight until the next fundamental opportunity arises, instead of just getting hungry and pushing all these fucking other artists that ain't being funny, but nobody really. It became a platform of, oh, I can't wait to see, like, Skepta versus Devil Man. I can't wait to see Kano versus Wiley. To who the fuck is that and who the fuck is that? Yeah, listen, clashing, bruv. That's what it came into, bruv. And then because of that, he don't get respect for it either. Because now what happens is, Yeezy will come up here and say, ah, oh, don't rate Jammer. But watch this. Even though it might have been out of greed or whatever, the man still tried to help other artists through his platform. You feel me? So, and help trying to help others is what's killed his thing.
Now, I understand what you're trying to do. You're trying to probably help the newer generation. Lord of the Mics is known for like the heavyweights, like Devilman Skepta. I think that's where it went a bit wrong.
I think even if that's where it went wrong, and regardless of anything else I said, I could be wrong, but I do genuinely think that Jammer does try to help the underground artists. Maybe he, you know, what you're saying is true, whatnot. But I do think the reason that Lord of the Mics has gone downhill is because the impact isn't there anymore. Like, you had the big fucking, the big branded iconics on there before, like doing, like going toe
but
to toe.
But you know what it is as well though? Perhaps the big dogs at this time didn't want to do Lord of the Mics.
They don't want to war with each other.
No, do you know what I mean? So that's why he's had to go down the route of maybe the younger generation or...
I feel like just because, all right, Yeezy, he's a big dog, yeah? But everyone in the world, everyone, like, you know how the industry is. Yeah. People might not look at you like that. Not everyone might look at you like that, like as the someone who's on that level. But you are, but you just haven't solidified it yet. So it's like, patience is a virtue, innit? Mm. Jammer should wait for an anticipated thing. Like, it will erupt. Like, it happens every now and then on Twitter. Like, you get like the Stormzy's and the Wiley's. Wait for a moment like that. And then bring it to Lord of the Mic.
But it's got to be with two people that people are going to take notice of. And in the last however many years, the only people that's really had it has been Stormzy and Wiley.
Stormzy, Wiley, Chip and fucking Bugsy Malone. Yeah, you know, those are Lord of the Mic. No.
Wiley and Stormzy, that would never have happened on Lord of the Mic. I don't think.
No, but this is what I'm saying. What? Why not? Stormzy was...
Because Stormzy
sent for fucking Wiley, though.
Yeah, I know. I'm not saying they wouldn't have clashed, but I don't think it would have been on...
fucked up everything.
No, they wouldn't have done it on that platform. They might have clashed, but they wouldn't have done it on that platform. Mm. Wiley would have. Stormzy wouldn't have done it on that platform. Mm. You hear me?
I don't even think Wiley would. I saw Wiley talking about it. Yeah, Wiley said, I'm going
to
make you... Yeah, he started saying like that, oh, too. But this is what I'm saying. This is
O2 or Lord of the Mics.
Stormzy and Wiley at the O2.
So would you rather see it on Lord of the Mics or the O2?
I would say Lord of the Mics, man.
I would say Lord of the Mics.
But the only reason I say O2...
Like, if you're a grandkid for real, and you understand what you're building and how things are and what needs to be done, you're going to invest into what needs to be done, bro. And the truth is, I believe, I could be wrong, that the best thing for in these historical moments of battle raps with Chip, Bugsy Malone, Wiley and Stormzy and that, they should take that shit to the
Should have been in the basement, but in a different age.
In the basement.
But then you've got to look at what each man tried to do. Stormzy said, come radio. Wiley said, come O2.
Wiley is smart enough to know that going in that basement with Stormzy is long anyway, if I'm honest with you. Because he's going to be saying a whole heap of Wiley stuff in his old school garage fucking grime jungle way. Yeah, and it's going to be like Stormzy's just going to cut through and just break him down to the public where you just look like a cunt. Do you get what
no
I'm saying?
No matter what.
So of course Wiley's going to say, no, let's clash in Jamaica. Let's clash in the O2. No, Stormzy. That, you know how he talks and does all of this? Like, you stray from the real. If you was real, I guarantee you, he would clash Dizzy
in
the booth, in Lord of the Mics. Stormzy, O2 Arena. Yeah. Never going to happen.
So right now, Stormzy is the king of grime, would you say, yeah?
As a grime kid, it's either Skepta or it's DWE.
It's crazy you say that, because a lot of men will stand up in there and put that. I would have said those two.
I would have said
that shit.
Stormzy didn't necessarily go through the struggle that Skepta and the man paved the way for. So it's got to be someone from that era. And for me, it's always either been like Skeppy or DWE, just because these are men that have, for the most part, stayed true to grime, especially DWE. But then Skeppy has maybe taken it places that DWE wasn't able to.
It was necessary.
But people in this argument, you've got to say maybe Jeremy and P Money as well.
All right.
Wouldn't you say that's valid?
P's cold. P's cold. And I would never take that away from him. He's cold. Like, when I think he went at someone and he used DWD's flow on One Extra one time, and I was fucking, I had it on repeat for time, you get me? But the thing with them guys, like you said, like they're the underdogs, innit? Do you get what I'm trying to say? I wouldn't say, when it comes to Kings of JME.
Yeah, what about JME?
JME's never sold out. The thing about JME, he's never done like nothing outside of Grime. He gets ratings for that, but as we all know, lyrically, he's not the best. But what he does is he does himself. Yeah. And we all appreciate JME to the point where no matter what he does, we're going to love him because we respect what he does. If anyone was to diss JME, you're going against anything you stand for, because he's always stayed true to himself. And that's something that I strongly believe in, and that I would preach to someone on the come up and advise them to do.
If the title King of Grime came around because of just who stuck true to it, then that's a different story, because then there's only a certain man that can be brought. Ooh. But you got to look at ability, you got to look at consistency, you got to look at success, all of the factors into one. And there's a certain level of people that fit that category and certain men that don't. You see what I'm saying? I'm not saying that Skepta is better than P Money, but Skepta has done stuff that P hasn't done. Okay. Same way, P is better in ways that Skeppy ain't. These are just things that have happened. But when you're looking for someone who has all of it and has done all of the above very well, then that's when you start to narrow your search. And that's when, for me, it comes down to Skeppy or D-Double. Because if it was just a matter of who's the more successful, then Stormzy's the King of Grime. You can't ask
No
that.
Way. Don't ever say
if
that.
If it was that.
No. If it was more successful. But we're not talking about successful. Right, the King Grimm goes far. Apart from Grimm, he said it. D-double, or Skeppy. Skeppy's cold, and like Skeppy's like only God knows like how like touch base, like how much I'm like a big fan of Skepta, bruv. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Like, I'm not, I don't care, innit? Like, keep it 100, fam. I've been from day dot, from production wise to the way he came in into the industry, just bars, the way he just was able to, like, you know, he's not the most lyrical, but every line, he just carries weight.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Every line carries weight. So, yeah, D-Double and Skepta, man. But more D-Double, because obviously Double has got, like, he's original, like, to the point where man's still spitting bars from Deja 923.
Mm-hmm.
Butter, have to understand what's going on. D-Double has cut through on lyrics that he probably wrote when he was your age. And he's doing the bits with I Care and rare, still doing the same, like, think you're a big boy because you got a beard. Like, he wrote that lyric when he was your age. He's probably, like, older than me. You feel me? So, yeah, man, D-Double, for the originality and persistence, because I don't even think Double's done anything outside of Grime or anything outside of, you know, that kind of tempo.
But he's never done anything. If someone asked me one name, I'd probably give him Skeppy. Skepta.
So in terms of Grime beef, how do you feel like things are different? Because back in the day, it was an on-site thing. You're going to see them at Stratford Rex, or you're going to see them on the roof. But now, it's like people are protected behind computers, maybe.
Back in the day, like, everyone was moving. Like, if you had a problem with someone and you was about that, you'd come for them. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, you'd be at a show or on radio or even a video shoot.
So anything happened that you can maybe shed light on?
Those are things I could shed light
where
on.
Where it's turned into real circumstances.
There was someone had a video shoot.
Can you say the name or?
No.
You heard the story.
I'm not saying no names, but man ran up in a video shoot. And just had everyone scattering like fucking, you know, they'd seen a ghost basically. the video shoot was in a club. We ran in there, turned the place upside down. All I remember seeing was like men, like, because we're in a club, yeah? The video shoot's in a club. I'm seeing like grown ass men push girls out the way to get into the toilets.
Oh, really?
Like, to get into the toilets and like things like that. I used to think that, like, in my mind, I'm thinking that, rah, like, it's mad. Do you get what I'm trying to say? But at the same time, it's like, yeah, man, certain things used to happen. My man were hiding in the like air vents. Like the artist whose video it was was hiding in the air vents. Do you get what I'm saying? He was there, we come for you, but you was hiding in the air vents, bruv. Like literally, you know, like 007, like man must have been in the silver panels, like on his knees and like hands, and like navigating, trying to get at, like he's escaping from the big ass. Like those kind of behaviors, and I'm like, oh, they're pushing gal out the way, they're in tunnels. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, mad. Yeah, them kind of things there still.
Yeah, that don't happen nowadays.
Yeah, yeah.
That definitely doesn't happen nowadays.
Especially, yeah, that don't happen no more.
Especially not in grime. In
yeah,
grime.
Man, that era's done. It's done out here. So I don't believe no one. Man will be out here talking smokes and mirrors, and then Dot Rotten, look at him. Look at Dot Rotten. That is what happened. That will happen to everyone who thinks they're bad in today's age.
Cool.
State of grime,
innit? State of grime.
Listen, I want to toast you, man, yeah? This is my first podcast.
Nothing killing
big up.
Like, pretend.
Oh, you can't, yeah, you pretend. All right, say nothing, man. First podcast, big up, Link Up TV, State of Grime, Dunlop.